Hello, my name is Amber Lujan at WFO Midland, Texas. As a part of this series on social media data mining, I'm going to cover how to use the geocode or location feature in your Tweetdeck columns. At the time of this recording, there is a winter weather event unfolding up in the Dakotas and Minnesota area, so I'm going to use the Grand Forks, North Dakota area in this example. So you can see here on my TweetDeck that I already have a search column set up for the word blizzard or snow in the tweets. And then I also added a hashtag North Dakota weather to further filter these tweets so that it decreases the chances of me getting a tweet that doesn't really pertain to what's going on up there. So the location or geocode feature is located in the filter options. Up in the right hand corner is the drop down or filter menu, and it's the second one down, location. If you hit the drop down arrow, you'll see that it starts off in London. But what you can do is you can type your location, which is a lot faster than zooming in and out and trying to make your way, you know, over to where you want to be. You can just simply type in Grand Forks. And there it is, Grand Forks, North Dakota. The default of the radius is 20 kilometers, so you can really needle in on the location that you're looking for. This will only show tweets that have come from inside this circle. So I'm just going to expand it a little bit to 50 kilometers and I'm going to zoom out. You can easily move this anywhere you click on this map. It's going to recenter your circle. Or you can simply click the X button and it will allow you to move the circle around anywhere you'd like. Expanding the circle even further, 100 kilometers, I can move the circle down to include Grand Forks and Fargo. So now I can get reports from all of these areas, and it will filter out any reports coming from outside of this area. The heaviest snow that's occurring at this time is up in Grand Forks and north. So I'm going to put my circle up near the Canada-USA border, and I am going to look through my tweets and see what I can find. Picture of blowing snow. Scrolling through here, this is a good one, change over from rain to snow, just outside Mayville. The roads are starting to slush up, so that's really good information for us to see as an NWS. So I've been discussing how to use the columns menu to format the geocoding filter, but there's an advanced way to do this if you really want to be precise, and that's by using the LatLon and customizing your radius. First, I'd like to point out the geocode format that you'll be using in your search bar. First, you want to start with typing the word geocode, followed by a colon, then you're going to put your latitude, comma, longitude, comma, and the radius that you're choosing. I do want to point out though that there are no spaces in your geocode string. So let me show you an example. Today I'm going to use the latitude and longitude for Grafton, North Dakota, which is around 40 miles north-northwest of Grand Forks. What I would type in my search bar is the word geocode colon, the latitude and the longitude, followed by the radius that I chose, which is 100 kilometers. One more thing I'd like to point out is you can really customize your radius. It could be as small as 0.1 kilometers or as large as 2,500 kilometers. So now I'm going to go back to TweetDeck and show you how to code it in your search bar. So you can see in Twitter at the top of my column, I still have the same search words as I did before, blizzard or snow, and hashtag North Dakota weather. Then you'll put a space and then you'll start your geocode tag. So type the word geocode with a colon, your latitude, comma, longitude, remember digits only, comma, and then your radius. Mine is 100 kilometers. After you hit enter, you're done. So a lot of good information you can find with the geotagging. I highly recommend using it during any kind of weather. If you've got, you know, a tornado or flooding going on, then you can pinpoint the location that you're really trying to focus finding reports. And so, you know, it's just a really great way to find that information. And that's all I have for using the geocode or location feature in your TweetDeck columns. I hope you check out our other data mining lessons in this series.